In this video, I'm going to go over the meaning of fractions, what it looks like, and different ways of thinking about fractions. And also then we'll go into equivalent fractions, which are used for reducing fractions. Also, we'll need them to add fractions, etc. We'll have to have an understanding of what that means to be an equivalent fraction. So we'll begin by talking about what a fraction looks like, for instance, and defining it. Well, we've got a fraction bar right here, and in the top, whatever's in the top is called the numerator, and below the fraction bar, whatever's there is called the denominator. So one meaning is if you have this fraction A over B, the numerator is how many parts you have, and the denominator is how many parts make up a whole. So for instance, if you had 3/4 of a pie, it would be like, well, you had a pie, and there were 4 parts, right? 4 equal parts in the pie. And if you want 3 of those parts, I would just shade 3 of the parts, and that would represent 3/4 of the pie. Now, what if you had 8 over 2? Let's just say you have a pie, and there's only 2 parts that make up one whole pie. And then you want to shade 8 of those parts. Right, I had to make up enough pies to shade 8 parts. And you end up with, well, that's what 8 over 2 means. But you can see you end up with 4 whole pies. So 8 over 2 also means 4. So another way of thinking about fractions is 8 over 2 means also 8 divided by 2, which will give you that number 4. So with that in mind, 3 over 3 means 3 divided by 3. That's just the number 1. And 5 over 5 means 5 divided by 5, or 1. 100 over 100 means 100 divided by 100, which is also 1. So in general, if you have the same number in the numerator and denominator, it's going to equal 1. Well, we're going to be using this idea when we deal with equivalent fractions and also with reducing fractions. Let's look at some special cases. What about if you have a 1 in the denominator? So let's say you had 10 over 1. This would just mean 10 divided by 1, which is 1. Or 8 over 1 would mean 8 divided by 1, which is 8. So in general, if you have any number in the numerator and you're dividing by 1, it's just the same thing as what's in the numerator. How about if you have a 0 in the numerator, like 0 over 8? That means 0 divided by 8, and that will be 0. Whoops. All right, so anytime you have 0 in the numerator divided by some number, let's call it n, this is going to be 0 if n is not equal to 0 itself. That's the last special case we have to do. What if you have, let's see, 6 over 0. This I do in another video about multiplying and dividing by 0. Anytime you have a 0 in the number in the denominator, it's undefined. Or if you have both 0 in the numerator and denominator, it's also undefined. Okay, keeping all that in mind, now let's use some of this to deal with equivalent fractions. So here's an example. Write some fractions equivalent to 1/2. Okay, so first of all, let's just see what it looks like. It's a pie, 1/2. I know that doesn't look perfect, but basically 1 out of 2. Well, notice if you would have taken the same piece and broken it up into 4 pieces and shaded the same amount, where this is 1 out of 2, this I've got 2 shaded out of 4 total. Or how about if I would have done it into, let's say, 8 pieces and shaded, you know, this whole side over here. Now I've got 8 pieces total to make up that whole pie, and I've got 4 shaded. So these are all called equivalent fractions because they're really representing the same amount of stuff. 1 out of 2, 2 out of 4, 4 out of 8. The easy way to get an equivalent fraction is you could multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. For instance, 3 over 3, because basically I'm just multiplying by the number 1. Now, to multiply fractions, what you could do is multiply the numerators and the denominators together. So I could do 1 times 3 over 2 times 3, and this is something you don't need to show, and you get 3 sixths. So that's another fraction equivalent to 1 half. So you pick any number you want, put the same number in the numerator and denominator, then you're multiplying by 1. So how about if I multiply by 15 over 15? Let's skip that middle step and go right to it. 1 times 15 is 15, and 2 times 15 is 30. So this is how we make equivalent fractions. Now what if we wanted to take 4 ninths and write it with a denominator of 45? So I need to make an equivalent fraction to 4 ninths so that the denominator is 45. So the trick here is to figure out what you multiply the denominator by to get 45. Well, 9 times what will give you 45? 5. All right, but if you're going to multiply by 1, you have to say the same number in both the numerator and denominator. So you're going to have to multiply by 5 over 5. And so my answer is 20 45ths is an equivalent fraction with the same denominator. Let's do another one. Let's say I had 4 sevenths and I wanted to write it with 42 in the denominator. So I'd have to think, what would I have to multiply the numerator and denominator by so that I can get a fraction with 42 in the denominator? So basically, I started out with a 7 in the denominator, and I end up with a 42 in the denominator. I'm going to have to multiply by 6 to get that 42. But I have to multiply the same thing in the numerator. So 24 would be up here. Now, it's okay if you'd like to simply extend the fraction bar like this and just put times 6 in both the numerator and denominator. That looks like a minus sign. Don't want that. And get exactly the same answer. All right, so you could either write it as 4 sevenths times 6 over 6, or you could just put 4 times 6 in the numerator, 7 times 6 in the denominator. And so this is all there is to equivalent fractions.